This video explains how to use the Debug UI Policies feature to facilitate testing and troubleshooting of your service catalog items. Click an item to go directly to that topic, or continue watching to cover all topics. Here we have a service catalog item that contains UI policies to display an additional variable field when one of these checkboxes is selected. We're using the JavaScript Debug window to monitor UI policies as they're executed while the user completes the form. If you have UI policies associated with a catalog item that isn't working as expected, this is a great way to troubleshoot. Before we get into how it works, let's take a quick look at some product documents you might find helpful. Here are the available debug options. This is the one we'll demonstrate, Debug UI Policies. Here's more on that topic, and here are instructions for using the JavaScript debug window. Our office chair catalog item contains several variables, including a label, two checkboxes, and two select boxes. Here are the UI policies that apply to this catalog item. This one shows a select box if the recliner checkbox is selected. Here's the when to apply condition, and here's the UI policy action that's executed when the condition is met. The variable field becomes visible, and it's set to mandatory. Let's enable Debug UI Policies and trace through the events triggered by this UI policy. UI Policy Debug is activated and stays active for the duration of our session or until we disable it. Now we need to display the JavaScript Debug window. We access our Office Chair catalog item from the user perspective through the service catalog. Let's clear the debug log to eliminate messages that don't apply to the UI policy we're investigating. Now, when we select the recliner checkbox, we can see exactly what happens with our UI policy and its related UI action. First, the system evaluates the conditions for the UI policy. We have only one condition, which evaluates to true. If we had other conditions, they would affect this outcome. In our case, the condition was exited with true. Because the condition evaluated as true, the related actions are carried out. The recliner angle field is set to mandatory, true, and visible, true. Now let's clear the recliner checkbox and see if everything happens as expected. Again, the system evaluates the conditions for the UI policy. This time the condition evaluates as false and is exited with false. So, mandatory and visible on the recliner angle field are set to false. This UI policy is working exactly as it should. If our catalog item weren't working as expected, we would systematically test all of its UI policies in this same way by manipulating them in the catalog while examining the debug log. We can change the size of the debug window by clicking these buttons and clear the log by clicking here. And when we're finished debugging, we disable UI Policies Debug and close the debug window. For more information, please consult our product documentation, knowledge base, or podcast, or ask a question in the ServiceNow community.